In the last video, we talked about Euler's method, which was a way of solving differential equations numerically. It had algorithms and formulas and no pictures. In this video, we're going to do the opposite. We're going to solve differential equations with pictures and almost no formulas. So let's suppose somebody gives us a differential equation. In other words, they give us a formula for dy dx as a function of x and y. Well, that means that whatever our solution is, if it goes through the point AB, that solution has slope f of AB. So let's draw a picture of all the possible slopes. So in particular, let's do it for the differential equation dy dx equals x plus y. So we know that if that goes through the origin, well, x plus y is 0 at the origin. So if it ever goes through the origin, it's going to have to be horizontal. And likewise, it's going to have to be horizontal everywhere on the line x plus y equals 0. Now, if we go through the point 0, 1, well, then x plus y is 1. So here it's going to have slope 1. Likewise, here it's going to have slope 1. Slope 1. Slope 1. Slope 1. If you go through the point 1, 1, it has slope 2. If it goes to the point negative 1, 0, it has slope negative 1. Let's continue this way. If it goes to the point negative 2, 0, it's going to have slope negative 2. And you can get a whole picture of what the solutions look like. For example, if you had a solution going through 0, 0, it would go here, and then it would start curving up. And it would probably do something like that. If you had a solution here, it would go straight down. If you have a solution here, through this point, you see what it's going to do. It's going to go forwards, and it's going to curve up some more. So, in fact, there are a whole bunch of different solutions. This is going to do something like this. This is going to do something like that. There are a whole bunch of different solutions depending on which point you start through. Your solutions, which are the green lines, are going to follow the directions of the direction fields, which are the red lines. The formula, y prime equals x plus y, allows you to draw the direction fields, and then the solution is just find a curve that is always going along the direction fields. So let's look at a couple more examples. First example, which I've drawn in advance, it takes too long to do it in real time, is y prime equals 2x. When x equals 0, the slope is 0. When x equals a half, the slope is 1. When x equals 1, the slope is 2. When x equals negative 1, the slope is negative 2. And you can draw solutions to this. You know, a solution will look something like this. Something like that, because I can't draw very well. Another solution might look like this. Again, there is a solution through every point. If I just give you the differential equation, that doesn't tell you what the solution is. If I give you a differential equation and a starting point, then you can work out the solution. Now, in this case, the solutions are actually pretty darn simple. They're y is equal to x squared plus a constant. You can see the derivative of that is 2x. So you have one curve here, another curve here, another curve below it. They're all parabolas, and they follow these lines. Another example is the direction field y prime equals y. Here, the higher up you go, the bigger slope you have. The farther down you go, the more negative the slope you have. There's one solution, which is just y equals 0. And then there are other solutions that look like exponentials going up or exponentials going down. There's a whole family of solutions. You tell me where you are at time zero, and I'll tell you where you are for all future times. Okay? And that's it for direction fields. Direction fields are a way of visualizing the differential equation and of telling you what direction you're supposed to go. In the next video, we'll combine this with some actual formulas and see how Euler's method and direction fields are really telling you the same thing.